Hey people, my name is Gerben and I've been a collector of vintage computers for a very, very long time. I also been selling them on eBay and I've been doing so for over 17 years because, how do you know? Because my oldest son is 17 and I sold my first computer on eBay a couple of weeks before he was born. And it was BBC B, I think, the Beeps. And it sold for 28 euros. And I was very happy with it a long time ago. And today the prices are a little bit different. And today we have got also a nice K-Pro. It's big and it's huggable and it's luggable. And let's have a look if it's working. And we have some more portable power and the next episode is episode 25, and it means that's something to celebrate. We're coming up to 300 subscribers, so that's very nice too. And let's do another giveaway, and next time you'll have to tune in to see what's been giving away. Let's have a look. Next up is another iconic portable computer based around the TRS-80, and I have already one of these, but it's American, so it's a different voltage system. And I bought a regulator that could bring down or bring up actually the voltage for the Netherlands, but I didn't come around to test it really, and now I bought another one. So The more the merrier. Let's have a look. The lady that sold me this one sends me sunny greetings. In every message she sends sunny greetings. Okay. And she told, she already told me that the clothes inside I can keep. No, I have to throw those away, I think. Anyway, she showed me this one. I'm almost finished buying another one from her, so I hope she packed it well. And let's have a look. Anyone has some small children? I think a boy will be fine. They smell fresh and they smell not dirty at all, but it's not used to me. But thank you anyway. Model 4 TRS DOS. Portable. Well, transportable, we know. I cannot really show you. It's the Radio Shack TRS-80 Model 4P, and I think somebody will be very happy with this. It's a kid's jumper or something. I can be an alien with my little ears, I think. I will throw it away or donate. Oh. You go skiing with your kids, I feel like a clothing channel or all of a sudden. Damn it, Gerben, we are here for the computers and not for the clothes. So let's have a look. And here's a little closer look of the very nice portable machine. It looks very vintage. Dual disk drive. Original keyboard. It came with one floppy. And if we are looking at the inside of the floppy, then I don't think we can use this. But luckily my other machine
came with a bunch of floppies, so we can test if it works. If it works, then we can test them. An original manual in parts, but still it's there. Nice. There's only one thing to do. We have to test it. So, will it go or will it blow? That's the question. Let's see. That's good so far. The floppy drive is not ready. Let's turn this down a bit. Yes. And we'll kill a light over here. Still viewable for you. Yes. Now, this is very nice. Let's turn it up a bit and turn this a bit. Yes. And I've got a floppy with TRS DOS. I have no idea how to operate these machines, but let's have a look. This is a nice reset button. Okay. Disk error, but it's doing something, eh? But we have more disks. Yes, that is the reset. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Let's not do this. 12, 12, 21. Sorry. 12, 12. I don't think you know. Let's make it 80. That's better. It's a nice machine, but it cannot live in the future. The screen is wobbly. I'm afraid it will go out any moment, but it's ready. Let's do there. Look at this. I hope you can see. I will. It's nice that you can see now, but I cannot see a thing, so this is not a solution. This is better. It's the screen is stabilized. Sometimes it just needs a little warming. Can we see what is going on? It looks excellent, I have to say. Don't say too much about the screen, my Ben, because it will jump links left and right. Let's try some software. Not this software, it seems. Let's try to boot from this. Superscript. Display directory. Which drive do you want to display? 0 to 7. You could up 88 discs on this machine, which seems a bit much, yeah? And here we go. Very cool. Oh, I hope the screen is holding on. Break, return. I thought that was a very nice another fine example of what this machine can do. No, this is not reading this disc, but it's funny that it's in English, in German, and in French. It seems that when the disk drive is on, the display is flickering. And if I close the disk drive and the screen goes unk. Another superscript. I think we want to see something else. It would be so much fun if there was a game on here. But I'm not really sure that we are that lucky. Multiplan. All these old machines have all the same software. It's taking its time. Oh, this looks like a spreadsheet. It is a spreadsheet. But it looks very nice and very, very vintage. There is a disc inside. Yes, now you read it. I just wanted to see if I can get drive B to work as well. No. There. E. Oh, there one? I'm not sure. Oh, here we go. This is how you learn. Trial and error. Okay, that didn't really work, but No. Too bad. I think drive B or drive 1, I have to say, sorry, needs a little bit cleaning. But anyway, I'm really, really content with this machine because it does what it should do. And I think I will make a set of discs for this machine as well, and I can test it with this machine, so it won't be sold very soon. But when I sell it, it will be a good thing to sell because I know that people are looking for these. Yes, happy again.
A little sneak peek of my American model Sirius 80. And it looks exactly the same as the other one. Yes, the next parcel makes me very happy again. And of course, I'm always very happy with all my parcels. But this big box is another vintage CPM machine, a portable CPM machine, all made out of metal. So maybe you know what I'm talking about. And I'm really, really happy with these because they are very rare to find. And if I can buy one for the right price, and if it's arriving at my home in one piece, I'm even more happy. And there's also a second computer in here, and I don't know so much about it, but let's have a look. Look at this big, big parcel. Oh, it's quite heavy. And I'm not sure if the lady who sold it to me used enough protection, but then again, these machines can take a beating. So let's have a look. First up is this nice portable machine. It's Toshiba, and it looks, it looks a little bit like one of the portables from IBM, I think. It's just the same little LCD screen. I think there was a problem with this, but somebody will be able to fix it, I think. Who wants to join me on a day on the beach? I have got some towels for us. And if it gets chilly, we have some hats also. It looks very good. It's a Capro 10. It's been a while that we had a Capro 10. And if I'm not mistaken, these have an internal hard drive and makes them more enjoyable. I'm not really sure if it was CPM or already MS-DOS, but we'll have a look. Oh, look, just look at this huggable, luggable beast. I cleaned it up a little bit, and it was really, really, well, I wipe it down with a soft cloth, and I can keep wiping because it will remove dirt and dirt and dirt and dirt again. But anyways, I'm really, really happy that I got one of these again, because they are very cool and big and bulky and full metal, so it's a little bit easier to ship because there's not so much chance that something will break because it's built like a tank. And the number 10 Capro, you don't find so often, and it does seem that it has the 10 megabyte ready hard drive. That was a lot of those days. Anyway, I've hooked it up, I've cleaned it, and we'll power it on remotely, and let's see what happens.
This looks fine. Yes. More lights come on. Oh, look at this. K-Pro 10, 1.9E. Very cool. And what happens next? Disk drives keep spinning, but let's see if it happens. Something happens. Let's try it again. Say bye bye. Too many beeps for the keyboard. I noticed that I cannot remove this disc. It's stuck in there. So that will be my first task, to see if I can change something over there. Okay. I cut the disc out. It was this disc and it was wobbly or whatever. It was very hard to get out. I have inserted a cleaning disc because that is our safest bet. See if it will work. Do I have to? Does try to load from the disk, I think. We'll repeat a few times. I know that there should be a reset button in the back, but I saw that the reset button was missing. Otherwise I would have used that. I know that I was wondering if it's CPM or MS-DOS, but now I have to admit that I'm made hundreds of discs for these machines and I know it has to be CPM. The number 16 is MS-DOS, I think. The only K-Pro MS-DOS, maybe. Now I've loaded the right boot disc. It would be nice if you did something. Try to flip the disc. You never know with these old disc drives how they're supposed to be. Look at this, something has happened, but I'm not going any further. Let's try again. Okay, after some cleaning, let's see if this disc works. Oh, look at this. Look at this happy, happy. Here it is, happy, happy Gerben. Gerben is happy. Gerben? Yes, Gerben. Look at this. And we can play some Zork, because this is the disc that has a Zork on it. And does this work? I don't think this works, but I'm not really sure. Oh, this works. Yes. It's a bit quick, I think. But well, very, very cool. This machine is a success, I think. I will have a look if I can make the other discs work as well. Beep. Yes, sir. Yes. Let's see what we have over here. Some more basic programs. So, 5 full. No, I'm feeling lucky. Let's go north. Yep. Go. I think this is a very fun game. Bird Star. Very cool. This works very well. Cool. I'm really, really happy with this machine, and somebody else will be very happy, because it's hard to find these, and especially if it's working as well as this one is. And now for the little base Toshiba. The lady who sold this to me, she wanted to test it first because she was thinking it would be unfair to sell something that wasn't working. Well, I get a lot of computers that not working, and I don't really care that much. The price I pay to buy them is a little bit different, but I know that these machines can stop working at any time, and well, they have to test it anyway, so let's see if we are lucky. Put some power on it. And nothing happens. That's not a really big surprise, is it? But we will test some other stuff, of course. First we have to see. No backlight, really nothing. Okay, we'll try the next step. I tried some other things, but they didn't work, so too bad. Somebody can maybe fix this. It will be a nice project. Sometimes I see stuff for sale that I don't even know what it is. But I'm so knowledgeable, but no, I don't know everything. The next thing I saw for sale, and I was thinking, well, I'm not sure what it is. And so I went on eBay and looked up the salt combs, and I'm not sure still what it is, but I know I want to buy and to sell it, because it should be something good. Let's have a look. Here we have the little colorful parcel. There should be a Russian doll inside, but I don't hope there is, because I hope there's something in that's a lot more worth. Let's have a look. Nothing in the box. But what did we buy? What is this? I think this is some kind of industrial little computer, and vintage, of course. It looks very nice and colorful. Roting NC Scriber SC100. I think it's used to to produce some funds for maybe for cutting or whatever. I have to say that the packing job is excellent. It arrived in one piece. And if it's industrial, it's not so much interesting to the vintage home computer collectors, but it is really, really important for people that still use these. If your routing died, then maybe I can sell you a new one. We'll clean it and we'll test it. Okay, cleaned up and hooked up, and I'm not really sure what this machine should do, but let's power it on. Error RAM defect, it says. I'm not sure if you can see it. Well, it does something. It's not completely dead. This is a, well, like a null cartridge. It's like a dummy. It's only plastic, as I can see, to protect this entrance. Oh, cool. Very cool. Press start. Okay. And let's see where I start. Start check. Oh, look at this. How funny. Should it plot? I'm not really sure. I'll test something else out. Let's see. This is very cool. Look at this, what it did. I'll shut it off. It doesn't shut off. Oh. Okay. I'm not sure if you can read this, but it does say Gerben was here. Very, very cool. I will try something else. Oh, sorry buddy, that's not where the paper is. Some keys don't work. Oh, this is the most fun I had all day. This is so funny. Okay, I think I overworked it, but let's assume that this is what it should do. And I hope you can read this. I always type in "buy me from Recompute 33" And I think I can show people on eBay that it's doing what it should do. Some keys don't work, but this is a very funny machine, I think.
We came to the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I really, really, really hate these videos, but no. I love making these videos, and I told you many times, and I hope that you liked this video too. And if you do, please like and subscribe, because that really, really, really helps. And I added some background music in these videos and in this one. And please, in the comments, let me know if it's a good thing or we should lose it. Sometimes I have to try something new. And we'll see. I hope to see all of you next time. Bye-bye.
The end.